700 calories, 20,000 steps. If you ever wonder how one of these fitness trackers works, well, if you have, listen closely, because with the 2017 4-H National Youth Science Day Challenge, incredible wearables, you're gonna build a wearable health monitor, detect movement, and measure your pulse. Today, you're gonna monitor your fitness levels by designing and building a wearable fitness monitor that's functional and looks cool. Then you'll study your results to figure out what needs to be adjusted so that it works right. Because that's what the engineering design process is all about. Trying it again and again and again. So it's time to work with your team and build the health monitor. Let's take a look at what's inside your kit. In your science kit, you will find one facilitator guide, five youth guides, a 12-by-9-inch piece of felt, Velcro strips to make a wristband, a small computer called The Thing, a pulse oximeter, a tilt sensor, a battery pack, and alligator clips. Before we get started, you have to learn how the devices work and what they measure. So refer to page 6 in your youth guide and review each component carefully. Today I'm joined by Virginia 4-H, and we're gonna talk about the fitness tracker because health monitoring using a wearable device is an interesting engineering problem. The idea is to connect an instrument that measures signals from your body and convert those signals to data that can then be analyzed. The problem for this challenge is to design a wearable device that tracks your biological data, like your pulse rate and movement, and use that to provide feedback on the activity level. Remember, your design should be small and not get in the way of the person wearing it when they move. Also, when we are presenting our scientific data, it's best to use the engineering design process. The engineering design process has three steps. First, defining the problem. Second, designing solutions. And third, optimizing the design solution. Your final design might be different than what you started with, even if it means losing less important features for those that are more important. Let's get started. In section one, the constraints holding you back for your engineering design problem include things like having only two sensors and having only 90 minutes to build. So think about what your design will look like using the two sensors and the thing and sketch it on page 10 of your guide. That looks great, guys. In step two, a resting heart rate is the lowest pumping frequency for a person not moving and is usually between 60 and 100 beats per minute. Physical exercise will elevate the heart rate. So by placing two fingers on your wrist, measure and record your heart rate at a resting period for 30 seconds and multiply your results by 2 to calculate beats per minute. Then record your answers in the chart on page 11. The basic circuit allows electricity to move. To do this, first you need to connect the power. Connect the power supply to the thing and power it up by sliding the power switch to the on position. Then you need to get it all connected. Make sure that the thing is functioning properly by connecting it through an internet browser using any device like a laptop, a phone, or a tablet. On your device, open your Wi-Fi connection and select the Incredible Wearables network. At this point, your device should connect to the thing. In your browser, enter the IP address. The thing will display the Incredible Wearables monitor website. In this part of the challenge, you will connect the two sensors to the thing. The first sensor you will connect is the pulse oximeter, which measures the amount of light that travels through an artery. To learn more about this, read page 17 of your youth guide. Follow the step-by-step directions in your guide to connect all the wires. You'll want to place the pulse oximeter on a pulse point of one of your team members. Power on the thing and open the IP address in your browser, making sure that the website is displaying pulse data. Connect the tilt sensor to the thing using alligator clips or directly connect the tilt sensor to the thing. Open the same IP address in your browser to ensure that the website is displaying data from the tilt sensor as you move it back and forth. A blue light on the thing should also indicate when the circuit is closed. Great job. You've built your first fitness tracker. Now you can explore various ways to wear it and track data. By this part of the challenge, you've completed the build of your team's health monitor, and now you can start to collect data for the group for both the resting and the active pulse. Each team member will collect information for each condition and then calculate an average for the entire team. Next, your team's going to look at optimizing the health monitor by placing the fitness tracker on your arm, your elbow, your wrist, or your hands. In this first step, part of the challenge is to creatively design how you will build and wear your device. Once you find a way to place the health monitor on a team member, record their average resting heart rate for 1 minute. Next, you can have one of your team members jog in place for 1 minute or do jumping jacks. And make sure to record your answers. Actually, there's probably a lot of other ways you can get your heart rate up. Now that you've completed your first full test, chat with your team about how you can improve your design. That's the engineering design process at work. Part of the challenge and part of being an engineer is failing and being able to try again. Take a look at your initial design and think of ways you can improve. Not everything will work, and that's okay. You can learn from your mistakes and fix them. If you want to learn more about how to make this into a job or a career, check out the last page of your youth guide. Thank you for being a part of the 10th annual 4-H National Youth Science Day.